Some people use orange juice instead of dairy in their cereal. Yeah.
That's some broke shit, right? To get some orange juice.
It's like, man,
that shit sounds sinful.
I'm just here, like, sharing information. I'm not saying I did this myself. Hey, what's going on? It's Trey, back for another Questionnaire Life. Today we have producer, performer, artist, dude, channel DJ. Yeah, Channel Trace with us. What's going on, man?
How you doing?
You ready to get into this?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, start off with some easy ones. Rank these real quick. Being in the studio, being on stage, or being on camera?
Being on stage is number one, because I turn into another person. I'm a pretty shy, reserved person if I don't know you, but on the stage, I don't really give a fuck. Next is being in the studio. I mean, that's the reason I'm on stage, and that's where you can like be yourself in a different way. When you're coming up with ideas and shit. I watch a lot of television and like court shows and like First 48 or something. Might be on Silent or a random documentary.
You just got like Judge Joe Brown on mute.
Judge Steve Harvey these days.
I forgot he has that show now, man.
And he's making a lot of money off of that. And then, yeah, being on camera.
Okay.
Being on camera is scary because it's like forever.
Yeah. It's true.
I'm like terrible at commitment, so forever is like.
What's the most important part of a live show? Nailing the stage effects, the choreography, or the vocals?
The vocals.
Like, what kind of stuff did you have to learn about like breath control and just like pitches and stuff?
Well, I learned that it's bad to do drugs and perform because your voice goes out, and maybe if you have a couple shows back to back, you might not want to drink or party that night because you probably might be winded the next day. And I learned that don't scream and cuss out the audience so much because you'll lose your voice by the last song. I've also learned, remember your lyrics. It helps.
How'd you learn that lesson?
By never having a problem with that.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ravioli, Hot Pockets, or Pop Tarts?
All that shit is bad for you. But whenever I was down bad, it was Hot Pockets.
All right.
I used to put ranch on them.
Oh, that's gross.
Bro, ranch on everything. I'm from the hood, so ranch on everything is like a must for me. Crazy.
Or ranch on spaghetti?
Yes.
You got a Taco Bell, squirt some ranch on top.
Yes, tacos.
Cheesy gordita crunch.
Crazy. Bro, ranch.
That actually could work, actually. Yeah.
I'm telling you, bro, ranch on everything.
All right. It's going to get some comments in the comment section. But, okay. Yeah. I think you're sturdy enough to, you know, handle yourself. Yeah.
I mean, I'm not lying to you.
Ranch on everything.
Ranch, bro. Except cereal.
So, I like the newest project, Refresh. It sounds like a little more pensive than your other stuff and all. Like, what were you thinking about while you were making this?
I quit doing drugs and shit, and was drawing some art, and a lot of those beats I made while I was, like, fucked up or had a lot of fucked up moments, or, like, I was hitting the refresh button on my life. Mm-hmm. Kind of wanted to be more in tune with my art and like not use it as a tool for me to just spew all my bullshit on, but use it as a tool to like make people feel good, make money, fucking play good shows, make people feel sexy. Like, I had to make a lifestyle change in order to do that so that the music can feel like that.
All right, so your social media is kind of bare. What are you trying to hide?
Nothing. I just didn't grow up on social media. I had like a flip phone until the age of like 22, 23. Mm. I got an iPhone because all my little cousins were talking shit about me. And then I made an Instagram in like 2015, and I made a Twitter like 2018. Part is just, I just don't know how to do it or I don't understand it. And I do music and I'm in the public for music. I'm an in-person type of person. I like my shows where I meet people. I like traveling.
Which of these negative Gemini traits fits you the best? Being judgmental, indecisive, or inconsistent?
Indecisive.
Mm. What's so difficult about making decisions for you?
Forever. Commitment.
Wedding ring, goddamn.
Like,
damn, dude, forever. You're doing this shit. Yeah.
I guess, like, commitment is good. When I committed to music and committed to this shit, it worked out, so.
Which provides more relief? Throwing up, taking a big dump, or a long pee?
Taking a big dump.
Okay. Why does that one top the list?
It's just something about taking a shit, like, or taking a dump. I answer emails. I reply back to text messages while I'm there. I might read a book. It's nice to know what you ate is coming up out of you. Shitting is something that's like very, very important to me because it lets me know I'm healthy.
Yeah, that gut health is important as shit, man.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
I'm like big like fiber gang and shit.
Definitely.
Yeah, I got that Metamucil in me.
Yeah, what do you eat to get like your fiber?
I got the Metamucil like powder.
Is that the shit, the orange shit?
Yeah. Gotcha. Yeah, they have a couple other brands, but they're sold out of the flavors I like, so you go get the Metamucil and shit.
Yeah.
Start your morning off with that. Make sure you got a vegetable at lunch.
Yeah, we sound like some old-ass fucking old-ass niggas.
I mean, we basically are. Yeah. You like 30, right?
Yep.
All right.
But I feel ageless, I guess, as you can say.
All right, this questionnaire life. It's Channel Trace, regular Trey. And see y'all next time.